thing. Of course, you're looking through a very long piece of atmosphere full of dust and pollution and so on, and that creates a redness. But at 11 o'clock in the morning, like it was here, yesterday, well, that's a pretty unusual. We had a couple of phone calls, in fact, from different colleagues this new phenomenon, and you know, one was a farmer, Tom Bruniok, who's in his 80s now, a good singer by the way, and he'd never seen anything, I never heard of it, and he phoned up, and it's
and
just
so
amazing.
What was he asking us?
Well, he was saying that, you know, this strange red stuff that he'd never seen this type before during the daytime, okay, in the morning and in the evening, but this is a new phenomenon, and you know, there's, I mean, but you can record it, and it's curious because we do have quite a bit of weather lore or signs, other signs of all sorts, looking at the atmospheric conditions, wildlife and things like that. But there's no reference anywhere to, you know, red sun during the day, you know? And so it's quite amazing. Unless you go to places like Australia or places like that, where you do get maybe just the haze creating redness at certain times.
But I prefer to come back to Professor Frederick, because he talks about the new scientific world, but that idea of the sky is really the end of the world.
Absolutely. I mean, and of course, historically, it is similar to what this is. And imagine the fear that that would have had in generations when people, first of all, didn't understand what eclipses were. And they were at that point unpredictable, because they're not now. And it looks as if in those places the sun is actually
the atmospheric conditions, wildlife and things like that. But there's no reference anywhere to, you know, red sun during the day, you know? And so it's quite amazing. Unless you go to places like Australia or places like that, where you do get maybe just the haze creating redness at certain times.
But I prefer to come back to Professor Frederick, because he talks about the new scientific world, but that idea of the sky is really the end of the world.
Absolutely. I mean, and of course, historically, it is similar to what this is. And imagine the fear that that would have had in generations when people, first of all, didn't understand what eclipses were. And they were at that point unpredictable, because they're not now. And it looks as if in those places the sun is actually a lot of interest survivors would engage in rituals like hunting drums and so on to try to put things right, try to get the demons go away. And of course, fortunately, those rituals all were just over, they continue to engage in.
Two layers, do you think it affects on the moon? Because of course many people read their horoscopes because of what's going on in the heavens to see what their mood is like.
Well, of course, the thing is that anything that's pretty unusual like this is not quite an impact, an emotional impact. But of course it is very important that people also take a real interest in the weather. Because, you know, if you're a farmer, then of course it affects your life, of course, you know, the weather, because you know, livestock or crops, you know, the time spent in the harvest. And if you're an inshore fisherman along the coast, then your actual life depends on you're able to read the sky and the sea. Because, you know, the big storms and danger situations, so it's crucial in the sky.
And you are a weather forecaster, aren't you? Of sorts.
Oh, absolutely, that's what I do with the maths these days, like, you know, they're quite good, they've improved quite a bit in the last few years. But a few years ago, when I was running courses, taking people out to walk for national parks here in Snowdonia, these are Stimboat, which is the Snowdonia National Park Centre, I found that my innate ability to read the weather signs from traditional folklore was far better than the detailed weather forecast from the RAF. Based at the valley, which is a few miles away. And, you know, so I became quite interested in collecting these things and thought that some of them are very, very effective, especially the ones who look at the cloud patterns and you know, the type of phenomena we're talking about. physical phenomenon. Because what we're doing is looking up at the clouds in the wind direction. Compared to my purpose, the satellite to look down in the direction of the edge. So we're reading the same sun, our local level, we do all sun.
We have it too. We must leave it there.
27 minutes past 8 o'clock. The best news ever, he said. And the new opponent for World Heavyweight Champion Anthony Joshua a week on Saturday in Cardiff, Carlos Tucker.
Foremost ornithologists and the world's leading expert on promiscuity. That's promiscuity in birds, I hasten to add. He'll be talking about his revelatory research on the ubiquitous cheating called